Good morning, good morning, good morning. Hey, y'all, I want to talk about, you know, will you still do it if nobody is pushing you? Because everybody in this trending thing of being a boss and all that, but will you still do what you say you're going to do? Will you still chase after that dream or that goal of yours if no one is pushing you? A lot of people don't even do what they do now if nobody was telling them to do it. So would you still have that go-getter mentality if nobody around you is doing it, if you don't have no type of motivation? Will you still get up and do it? Will you still get it done if nobody is pushing you to do it? Good morning, Dolo. Good morning, Mr. Harris. Good morning, Christian Thompson, baby. Ebon the Mechanic, what's poppin'? Will you still do it if no one is pushing you? A lot of people don't even have the drive to do what they say they're going to do. And then people sit around and talk stuff about what they want to do and then get mad when somebody holds them accountable for doing that shit. You better be careful of saying what you're going to do because somebody might challenge you on that. Okay? People need to learn that. Eric Thomas, what's popping? Miss Perkins, how you doing? Good morning, y'all. We talking about, will you still do it if no one is pushing you? Will you still get up when you lacking the motivation, when you lacking the drive? Good morning, sis. My baby body genie. Brittany Hayes, what's popping? When you lacking the drive, will you still get up and do it? Everybody talking about they bossed up. But when you ain't got the motivation around you, will you still get up and get it done? When this shit going wrong in your life, are you still gonna go? Huh? I don't think so. What's up, Xavier? Good morning. Will you still go if nobody is pushing you to do it? Does somebody have to tell you what the fuck to do all the time? You need to go get a job, a 9-to-5, if you got to be told what to do. If you ain't got no sense of direction, what's guiding you in your life? What's guiding your footsteps? Okay, good morning, John. We talking about, this is just one of my daily affirmations, you know what I'm saying? Dime talks. We talking about if no one is pushing you, will you still go? If nobody is telling you to do it, will you still do it? Will you still get up and go and do it? That's why a lot of people ain't sticking to their words and saying what and doing what they say they're going to do because they lack the drive for themselves. You know, you got to be a self-starter. I'm looking for self-starters. Like, I don't want to have to tell you everything to do. Use your creativity. Use your imagination, most importantly. You know what I'm saying? Like, common sense. Fall in. What's up, Tisha? How you doing? Brittany Hayes says, it's hard and it takes a little longer. Definitely, it's going to be challenging, especially when you're doing it by yourself. When you're starting off by yourself, of course, you're going to have to find the missing pieces to the puzzle because you ain't going to have them all at that time. It might take you a little time, but it ain't nothing wrong with that as long as you keep the momentum going, as long as you stay focused on what you said you was going to do. You can't have the expectation of others until they prove themselves. You know what I'm saying? So you still got to get up and go. You still got to get up and go. I know people be tired of me telling my story, my life story, how my mother passed away when I was 17 years old. But I use that as that's fuel to me. Because nobody tell me what to do. Nobody, like, I've been lost that. You know what I'm saying? As a little one, I've been lost that. So with that being said, I had to pull myself up and just take on all responsibilities. You know what I'm saying? I was my own mother and father and brother and sister and cousin and whatever, mentor. And, you know, you got to be that for yourself before you can be it for anyone else. That's all I'm saying. So when you at that level of your life, when nobody got to tell you what to do every day, when you just wake up with the self-motivation and the drive to do it on your own, then you can motivate others. Then you can give advice and shit like that. Share your knowledge and your experience. But until then, nobody is listening to you. Like, you gotta prove yourself out here more, like selling yourself. And don't get it twisted, like, forget what people think and say about you at that point when you going after something. That's what I'm saying, because people will get it twisted all the time. What's up, Lisa? What's up, Mac Lowry? What's up, Jason White? Kaiser Sharp? What's up, y'all? Are you gonna still go when nobody is pushing you? Think about that for a minute. If everybody around you is just sucks, like nobody is on your level, nobody is thinking like you, what you gonna do about that to change it? Do people have to push you to do shit? Like, that's more like a 9-to-5. I can't see myself working for somebody all my life, because I don't need nobody to tell me what I need to be doing. Okay? That's that type of mentality. If you got to be told what to do, you know? And don't get me wrong. You need jobs. You need somewhere where you can learn the business model or some shit like that. You need discipline. You need to get up every morning and be on time for shit. Just start being consistent with yourself. You know what I'm saying? You need that. Erica Clemens, good morning. We talking about, will you still do it if no one is pushing you to do it? Will you still do it if nobody is telling you what to do or giving you the blueprint or giving you, showing you the way? Or, you know, sometimes you don't have that in your life. You got to start somewhere. And then as you start being more serious about yourself and being a self-starter and motivating yourself and getting shit done without somebody telling you to do it, you start to attract those type of people in your life that want to take the load off for you, that want to help you, that want to help you get there. You know, you can't motivate nobody until you motivate yourself. Don't nobody want to follow nobody lead who ain't doing what the fuck they said they was going to do. From the beginning, I'm not following nobody lead who can't back up what they say, period. Keith Brockman, what's poppin'? We talking about, will you still do it if nobody is pushing you? Everybody got the mentality, they gotta be pushed to do something, you know? And don't get me wrong, sometimes you need a little motivation, sometimes you need a little inspiration, a little dime talking every now and then. You need a daily dose of dime. I highly recommend it. But at the same time, don't just use what I'm saying and just, like, put it off to the side. No, put some action towards what you said you was going to do. And this coming from somebody who does exactly what I say I'm going to do. Now, you know, you might have detours and you might have to change up your plan and all that. But for the most part, you see me doing exactly what I said I was going to do. Sometimes I don't even speak on what I'm going to do and I just do it. That's even more of a valid reason to pay attention to somebody who doing it. Like, okay, she know what she talking about. She know how to manifest. She know how to make shit happen and come into reality. Everything starts from the mind and idea. Now work towards bringing that idea into reality and manifesting it. You know what I'm saying? Jordan Richardson, what's good? Good morning. Yeah, we talking about, will you still do it if nobody is pushing you to do it? Jordan, what didn't you say you gonna do something? I'm holding you on that. Like, I'm holding that against you if you don't get it done. I'm that type of friend. Friends don't just come around me telling me they want to start a business, because I'm on your head, I'm on your ass, I'm asking you about it. And some people get uncomfortable with that because they're not used to people holding them accountable. Their own parents don't hold them accountable because their own parents don't believe they can do it. Why? Because they ain't doing it. You can't blame nobody for not believing in you when you don't believe in yourself. I don't care if it's your parents. Sometimes parents know their kids ain't shit. They just don't want to say it. But at the same time, you can turn that around and you can change that and make them a believer out of you once you start doing what the fuck you said you was going to do. If you said you was going to take out the trash, take out the fucking trash. Why do I got to keep telling you every day to take the trash out? That's what I'm talking about. Simple shit. People can't even do basic shit but want a motherfucker to believe in their dream. You ain't even done basic shit. You don't even have a routine or a schedule. Let me look at your calendar. What's all on your calendar and your phone? Let me look at that. Let me look at your friends. Let me look at your surroundings. Let me look at what you doing every day. Your daily behavior. Because that create habits. Good or bad. Jordan said, I got a side job this weekend. I'm holding you to that. I'm calling you this weekend and I'm saying, Jordan, did you get that done? Which I know Jordan, he for the most part do what he say he gonna do. So, you know, it be all fun and games when I talk shit to Jordan, because he understand where I'm coming from. He know that I'm not gonna sit up here and talk about nothing or try to tell somebody to do something and I ain't doing something myself. You know, that ain't how I rock. And I can appreciate people around me that do the same thing, you know? You gotta love and appreciate that, because that get other people going like, damn, let me get my shit together, period. You know what I'm saying? Jordan say, picked up 4 properties I'm maintaining now. That's what the fuck I'm talking about, Jordan. We gotta get up and celebrate. That's another thing. When you put your mind to doing something, nobody ain't got to tell you what to do. You got to celebrate along the way. I don't care how small or big the accomplishment is, because you got to get in the mindset of winning. That's a winning mentality. Like, you got to start celebrating that shit. Even if you celebrate by yourself, treat yourself to, you know, something special. Do something good for yourself, you know? So, hey, that's just a lot. You got to make that a part of your lifestyle. Doing stuff like that for yourself. But yeah, will you still going if nobody pushes you to do it? Will you, and when you sick, if you sick, will you still, you could be weak as a mug, but still pick up the phone, do a little research, do something. It's always something that needs to be done when it comes to your dream. It's always some, go back and tighten up on something, reevaluate last year. You know what I'm saying? You got to start measuring your successes and your losses so you can know how to do better, period. And it ain't nothing wrong with that. People be afraid to look back at poor results. But you got to look at the poor results in order to know how to do better for yourself. Katy Perry, baby, what's popping? Good morning. We talking about, this is my daily affirmations. I think I'm finna start getting in the habit, while I'm talking about daily habits, I'm finna start getting in the habit of maybe creating daily affirmation videos. I don't know if y'all know, but I be up at like 4-5 in the morning. I gotta push myself to be up, because my morning is my self-care time. I might take a long time to get ready to leave out the door, but that's my self-care time, where I'm, you know, I might take my shower. I might, you know, just do a little, some type of fitness, workout, stretch, meditating, listening to some positive meditating music, you know, stuff like that. Just getting your mindset ready for your day. So daily habits creates your future, basically. You know what I'm saying? So we gotta get in the habit of doing things like that for yourself. And nobody is pushing me to do that. Who the fuck wanna get up at 4 a.m? Just being honest. But I set that goal for myself, and I've been doing it myself. I'm an early bird anyway, because I want all the worms. I don't care, but I'll take your worm if you still sleep. And it ain't stepping on nobody's toes. But hey, if it's something that's in demand, I'ma go get that, because you don't want it. Eve Smith, how you doing, baby? Ariel Whitaker, what's popping? Katy Perry said, I love it. Thank you. You know, and nobody pushes me to do these things. So I will push you to do things, but I'm going to be able to back up what I'm saying that I do in order to push you. You can't push nobody to do nothing if you ain't doing it yourself. Most people don't even listen to their parents, because their parents ain't shit. And not to diss a parent, because parents do the best that they can. But when you want something more and you know what you want, nobody can't tell you. You don't take advice from somebody who not doing walking the talk or walking the walk with you. You know what I'm saying? That's just real. I use real life examples, real things, no matter how harsh it may sound, but it's harsh reality. You know what I'm saying? So will you keep going, and will you keep moving if nobody is motivating you or pushing you? You're gonna be an adult more than you're gonna be a child. You spend most of your life, you know, if nothing happens to you prematurely, you spend most of your life as an adult than you do as a child. Okay? So that's why it's very important to start creating those daily habits in your kids, so that they can know and they can grow up and, you know, be disciplined and responsible and be self-starters. You know, I ain't finna, I'ma tell you to take the trash out, but I don't have to keep telling you to take the trash out. That's the thing. Baltimore Hampton, what's poppin'? Jelly, what's poppin'? Y'all, we talking about, will you still do what you said you was gonna do if ain't nobody on your ass about it? Only people that should be on your ass about something is your job. Besides that, even at your job, once you know the job, it's the same shit every day, unless you got a job that just change all the time. Once you got a job, you know what to do. Nobody should be telling you what the hell you should be doing. You knew what you signed up for. They trained you for probably 2 weeks to a month. So after that, you know what you're supposed to be doing. Now, if they changing policies and changing the structure of the business and all that, then yeah, you're going to have to be retrained. And more than likely, companies already know that. That's why they're going to keep your ass in some type of training and certification so you can get better so that you could fulfill the job. Okay? This shit is not rocket science. Just pay attention to the business models and use that same mentality to run your own shit. That's all I'm saying, y'all. It's not that hard. And the best thing about running your own shit is you make your own rules. You make your own, you may not like your boss rules, but with your own shit, you can make your own rules. You pick who you want to work with, because I know a lot of y'all don't like y'all coworkers. And that's fine. That's why you make changes. If it's something you don't like, you have to make the necessary changes. But nobody shouldn't have to tell you to do that. You a grown ass person. It's so many grown wannabe ass people, but you gotta tell them what the fuck to do. Sometimes more than once. That's so annoying to me. Don't ask me for my advice and you don't use it, because I'ma drive your ass. Baltimore Hampton says, spoken like a true go-getter. Okay, baby. That's what I'm talking about. I've been doing this shit. I've been backing up everything that I say. PD Mac was popping. I've been doing this. Anybody that know me know for a fact that I'm gonna get that shit done. Whatever the fuck she say, it might sound ridiculous at the time, you know, and people might put it off at the time. So hey, once I tell you once, I shouldn't have to say it no more, because I'm gonna do it. And I expect the same thing from people, especially people in my circle. If you told me something once, I'm not gonna be on your ass like you my child. That's not my job. Everybody is grown. You heard me? But don't think I ain't paying attention. And don't think I ain't, you know, making a plan B, because I see what you showing me. Period. Derek D. Black Perryman, what's popping? We talking about, do I have to be on your ass about something you said you was going to do? Will you still get it done if nobody is pushing you to do it? Huh? When you lacking the motivation or the drive for that particular day, because people go through shit in life. But are you going to stop? You got to still give the effort. Even if it's a little bit for that day that you having a bad day. Just put in a little bit of effort. It don't take much. If it's especially working on yourself or working on your business. You know? Do a little bit. Get a little bit in. You want a journey to make yourself look better physically. Okay? Every day, that's a tough line. Look. To try to get fit and stay in shape, that is very challenging. First of all, in your mind, to even get up and go to the gym or go, you know, it's easy to go sign up for the gym membership. But once you go to the gym that one time and you got your ass whooped because you don't know what the hell you're doing or what the hell you signed up for, you lack the motivation. That can be a challenging thing to stay consistent with. So again, even if you don't go to the gym that specific day, you may do something at home. And it don't take much, y'all, but daily habits create your future. It don't take much. You get a little 20, 30 minute workout every day, that make a difference than you going to the gym every New Year as your resolution. Just keeping it funky. Yeah, think about what I'm saying, though. I ain't saying nothing wrong. Nothing is discouraging. This should be encouraging. You know, don't be offended by what I say. It may come off strong, but you need that in your life. Because everybody keeping it, making it too easy for you. If you ain't growing, somebody ain't keeping it real with you. Somebody ain't, you know, telling you the truth. Period. And I don't want nobody around me that ain't telling the truth. Telling me the truth. Okay? Demetrius Hampton was popping. Yeah. I need some Theraflu, y'all. This weather, I don't know what's going on, but I'm still going. I'm keeping going. You know what I'm saying? Through sickness and health. You need to marry yourself. You will marry somebody else and propose to somebody else a plan or a dream, but you ain't keeping it real with yourself or proposing or committing to yourself. So how I'm going to take you committing to me seriously? Eventually, that ain't going to work out. Lashay Mitchell, what's up, sis? We talking about will you still keep going. Now, I know my sis, she on this keto diet, and she been going hard for herself, making changes, making this shit a lifestyle for herself, because she said, fuck that. I'm tired of living like this. I want changes in my life. And I respect anybody who wake up one day and be like, this ain't life. I'm ready to start living. But it get hard. It's easy to just say, okay, I don't want this. I want to do better. But it get very hard to stay committed to yourself, what you said you was going to do. Like I was saying, it get hard to go to that gym. Some people have workout buddies, and that's a good thing because they know it's hard to keep yourself motivated to working in the gym, working out, and all that. That's one of the most hardest things to do and stay committed to. One of them. Another most hardest thing to do and stay committed to is your dreams. The things you want in life. You gotta go after that. You gotta go after that like there's no tomorrow. You know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta go after that like somebody is chasing you. Like, you in fear of your life. Yeah, you in fear to keep living the same life and repeating the same life that your people used to live. That should be your motivation right there. I'm scared to go back and live that life. So let me keep going. Let me keep making changes. And let me keep doing something different than what I was taught or brought up. You know? That fear should be motivation. That fear should be motivation, y'all. So when nobody else is pushing you or telling you to do it, you got to do it for yourself. I don't care if it take all this in you. You got to get something done. I don't care. You got to find something that's going to keep you going, y'all. I don't care what it is. Okay? Katy Perry said, there you go, sis. Right on, sis. I'm glad somebody hearing me. I'm glad I can make a difference in somebody's life. You feel me? Because look, it's a blessing, man. It's a blessing to have people in your life that's outgoing, that's, you know, that's doing it, man, that's really and wants something for you, that can speak life into you. That's a blessing to have, because everybody's speaking negative. Everybody, you know, just down, and they don't know what to do or how to go about things. So it's a blessing when you have somebody that's keep going. You know, a person might have said 10 years ago what they said they was going to do. And a lot of people forget what people said they was going to do. But it's just such a blessing and so refreshing when you see them 10 years later and they still doing exactly what they said they was going to do. They got to be motivation, y'all.